What's up, guys? Welcome back to Persona. Yeah.
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm going to be running the stream and also commentating at the same time.
Go.
Yeah, because Josh is actually in pool one with LK. It was a very hard pool.
Multitask god.
Yeah.
Yeah, so who's in the pool with him?
Josh, okay. LK. I believe those are the two
killers
that are noted in that pool. There might be some landmines, you know. It's Persona. Yeah. Anything can happen.
Yeah,
especially
sure.
This version is so volatile. Yeah. It's so very volatile. Josh doing his job right now. Oh, man. Florida is just so hot. It's so different, yeah.
Dude, I had to change because, like, I was in full clothes. Like, yeah? That's not happening, yo.
Yeah, like, I don't know, like, the weather feels very, very muggy.
It's humid, dude.
It's very humid, yeah.
I hate it.
It looks like it's going to be a...
Okay versus...
Right. Trying to figure out what the second player is going by. We actually don't have a bracket runner actually telling us.
Oh, and we need...
Yes, so we do. Blue561.
Blue561. Right. Memorable name. Alright, here we go. Going to the game. Alright. Blue light from Foster's home, okay.
Yeah.
Right,
he's rocking that blue color too. But you know, I have to play against Alkay, who's definitely one of the favorites to win this tournament.
Oh yeah. He had such a strong showing at Texas Showdown.
Oh man,
last
he
time
was
I saw him.
Something else. And he's just getting better and better every time. With Evo coming around just around the corner.
Yeah.
Nice awareness from Blue to DP that short hop.
First to stay alive right now.
Blue really needs to get an awakening right now.
Yeah, he wasn't.
There we go.
That's all I was about to say.
Ooh, wow. Actually, that dive kick hit the Persona. And Lord Knight with his favorite option. Like,
is this it?
Let's see.
Yeah. Yep.
That all combo right. Does so much damage, no matter what starter.
Yeah, pretty pretty convincing first round.
Oh, very neutral start from Lord Knight. Ooh.
Really
might have messed up an option select right there.
And now he's got him in the corner.
Ooh. That was very tricky. That was so tricky.
Oh, overhead.
Okay, actually dropping his combo.
Ooh. Oh, I thought he was going to get a punish off
that. It's harder. It's hard to punish it at that angle. You have to hit her at like almost the peak of her 2D.
Okay.
Ooh.
Ooh. All right, Blue's getting some work put in right now.
Nice block. Oh, wow. Okay, so sliding right under.
Anti-air slides.
Safe jump.
Nice.
Yeah.
He's gonna
okay, his fuzzy jumps are of something else. And the anti-air 5A.
Oof. He's got to do something. Oh,
yeah,
that's
no. Okay, is showing complete dominance of this matchup right now.
Yeah.
Very something he had to learn because of a Grover Shades of NEC.
Yeah.
That was a very good match, but unfortunately he lost.
All right.
So straight into the second match.
Yeah.
Very neutral round start again. Oh. Now, when Margaret actually whiffs that 236D, she is in so much recovery. It's ridiculous. Like, at least, like, 60 frames.
Okay.
Okay, dropping his combo.
Yeah. It's the first Persona game of the day, though. So.
Yeah. He said he didn't want to buy because he needed a practice.
God.
It was very LK-like.
How demoralizing is that?
Oh, wow, yeah. There you see another one of his team that was just getting hit, and she was stuck in that counter hit recovery for so long.
Ooh, catches the slide. That's a burst.
Lots of spacing going on. I think LK is trying to 5A those fireballs. Oh, EX command grab.
Nice. Should be it.
Yep. Nice. Decent. Blue looking up.
Yeah, taking around. Here we go.
Very neutral. Sprong start again. Blue is very afraid of Lord Knight.
Yeah,
as well as you should be. Ooh. Unfortunately, no combo with that 5B. Yeah.
Whiffs the grab.
Oh, he tried. Fatal.
Oh, fatal counter. What?
Not sure what he was trying to do there that he got fatal. Probably, yeah, that. There we go. That's why. Yeah. He was trying something, yeah.
Hail Mary.
LK.
Oh,
with a very rare DP. I rarely ever see LK use that DP.
Almost burst to save his life right now.
Ooh, ooh. Safe jump.
Good block.
Punish. No. That was heartbreaking. He could have killed LK right there.
Yeah, he could have had it.
He had if he just micro dashed a little bit, he would have gotten that 5C and a slide across slash.
Hopefully doesn't rattle him too much. He's going straight into it. He's really aggressive in this game too.
Whoa. Full screen. Nice. LK is just controlling the zoning like so well. Like his spacing right now is very strong.
Ooh.
Unfortunately, he's stuck blocking right now.
Yeah. Nice anti-air.
Blue. I would have opted to DP right there from Blue.
Ooh. What's he got?
You need to DP. Blue had to. Okay.
There we go.
An awakening anyway now.
Oh.
No rapid.
No punish.
Oh.
That's it? Nope.
Yes, that's it.
Oh. Yeah.
Lord Knight, wow, Blue looking up right now.
Takes
all right.
The game.
Immediately, I feel like the rematch button is like a blessing and a curse.
Yeah.
Because the second player could be like if you lose or something, you kind of want to like take a break sometimes or whatever, but like the other player is always.
Smash, yeah. Yeah, like going back to character select to think is, you know, a solid strategy in fighting games. This is 2 out of 3, so Lord Knight's got to play.
He's gotta start doing some stuff. Ooh, Blue trying to go for that the tricky delayed jump Z combo.
Ooh, ooh.
I feel like LK's taking all the breaks off right now.
Yep.
Whoa. J2B, the hitbox makes no sense.
Just to hit him.
Yep.
Okay, burst keep him in the corner.
Ooh, wow.
Slide out.
Slide.
DP's into awakening. Good.
Nice.
Ooh. That was good.
Safe jump.
There you go.
Now that combo is not easy to do. I'll tell you that right now. Lord Knight just showing how much
bad
practice he has with this character. He has basically learned Margaret in and out now. Counter hit? Oh, no combo.
Yeah.
There's the late 5A.
Oh, slides to.
Counter hit 2B yet again.
Combo. Ooh, that's some damage.
Yeah, all the way in the corner also.
Yeah, 4K corner carry.
Is Blue gonna burst here? He should.
He should.
And it's gonna be over. Yep. Oh, that's for safe.
Wow.
Oh,
okay,
no.
Showing that he was, you know, he let Blue get under a game, but then shot back.
Yeah, Blue really showed himself out here. He was.
He did.
I'm not sure if LK was getting his fuzzy jumps right because he was getting counter hit by a lot of stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
The fuzzy jump is such an important part of the game. Like, you have to play around fuzzy jumps now.
Okay.
Especially, if you see the Japanese play, like, they do a lot of, like, weird things that you're like, why would they ever do that? And it's, most of them, it's, like, revolves around either baiting the fuzzy jump or seeing if you do fuzzy jump.
Okay. All right, so now we got Josh versus...
Dave's not here. That's like a very unique handle.
Yeah, I might get you DQ'd from some tournaments.
Dave's not here. Is Dave not here?
Yeah, just crossing up. I don't know. Someone put that. Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, okay, okay. Sorry, man. All right, so what are with these queen alts? The shirts with all the queen cards on it. Is that Persona? Or what is this?
What do you mean?
The shirt that Josh is wearing. This guy's wearing the same thing.
Oh, the cards? At AX, they were selling them. Okay. I remember that. I don't know if they're actually selling them anywhere else, though.
Okay. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't know if it was a team or something.
That'd be awesome. No. Yeah. No, it's not. All right, so Josh looks like he's opting to play Minazuki in this matchup. Colors are very important, guys. Okay, so Minazuki versus Labrys is kind of a mall fest. Like, this matchup's so hard for Labrys because he can just stand at 5A range on her wake up, and if she tries to DP, it's just going to get blown up.
Okay.
And it's just so oppressive in his nature and his gameplay. It's just Labrys not very Labrys friendly.
Yeah. All right, so see, they kind of backed off. Okay, good anti-air.
Is the crouch confirmed? Third corner. Mess this up this
air jump low. Wow.
Okay.
All right, Labrys getting the game started.
Whoa. Now, Josh is very DP happy.
Yeah. All right, she's in awakening, gets grabbed.
There we go. Ooh.
What she got? Pushing him into the corner.
Oh.
DP's out.
Yeah, he tried to go for something a little fancy.
Wow.
2A, 2A into a delayed sweep.
Nice.
Not sure what Dave's trying to do right there, but... Oh, yet again, maybe something's wrong, like, because that was a full screen grab almost.
Yeah.
Joshua not reacting to that DP. Josh is trying to get a low cue right now.
Alright,
teleport one again. Not sure why Josh did not finish that combo right there. Dave was not no burst. No punish on the DP either.
Oh. Wow, gets blown up.
Okay.
Ooh, good teleport. And
yep,
that's it.
There we go.
Game one, Joshua.
Now, Josh, if Josh keeps up this kind of gameplay, like, he's not going to fare well against Lord Knight because he's not doing a lot of things he should be doing that should make this matchup a lot easier. He should not have been able to get DP'd.
Yeah, he should not be having this much trouble right now.
Oh, wow. Round start. Sweet. DP. Ah, there we go. Not going for the optimal punish, but I respect it. Fast punish.
There you go. Good teleport.
Good awareness from Dave to not press any buttons after the teleport.
Oh.
Oh. Whoa.
DP's is DP.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, a little bit too far. Not dead yet.
Good combo.
All right, no, he just got the meter, but...
There you go.
Now, Labrys and Blue Axe. She's going to have to play very, very safe.
Yeah, she has a lot of work to do.
I mean, Labrys herself takes a lot of work, but especially against Minazuki, like, the neutral is just so hard. The neutral is very hard to play. Dave not here might be just messing up his fuzzy jump. Getting from max
awakening.
Damage. There we go.
Blows up the DP.
Josh is finally waking up.
And
first save.
Messed up the one more burst, but this could be the run back. Come on, Labrys.
Oh, no. I think he tried to be a chain.
Okay. All right, so 2-0.
Josh showing up. Why West Coast is here. Where's this mouse?
It's on the guy's face right now. I can see it on my screen. It was there.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
There we go. Okay.
All right, guys. We found the mouse. We did it.
mouse pointers are very hard to find.
For sure.
Shout out to Soji for being here also. You can see him in the background. He won Blaze Blue yesterday.
Oh,
very
yeah?
Very convincingly. Yeah. There was nobody that could really fare up to him. Valkenhayn. Like, we talked to him. He was like, yo, Soji, very strong. And he's like, no, Valkenhayn is strong.
Hey, at least he's giving credit where credit's due for something.
You know, yeah, yeah.
All right, so Soji's
so the first victim for Soji is...
Oh, yeah, I don't know who this is. I should know who that is. Looks familiar.
His name is Mexican.
Never mind, never mind.
So, Soji, I played him in casuals, and he's got so much stuff that just, like, I cannot press a button because okay. I am in lockdown and block stun almost 70% of the time.
All right, it should be interesting to watch.
And then knowing Soji, he's going to do a button check because
of the incident
that happened a little bit while back.
Okay.
Now, these are the longest button checks in anime I've ever seen.
Pretty much. I'll take anime button checks over Smash coaching, though, any day.
That is true. Hand warmers are very, very long. Oh, man. I was over in Chicago, we had a tournament with Mewtwo King.
Yeah.
He checked us out or whatever, and I think he did like hand warmers for like 5 minutes on stream
yeah,
or something.
Yeah, he'll play a full match as a hand warmer. Like,
yeah.
That's what he needs, apparently. Yeah, it's ridiculous.
I mean, good for them, but it's a little bit too long for me, you know?
Yeah.
I play fighting games. I want something fast, and that's why I can't play single player games anymore. Yeah. It's like it takes too much time.
Can't you just sit there and like not have to see it and just do it before
yeah,
you game?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, all right. What? So we got
Adachi versus Teddy. Now Adachi's so scary. It's like he's not that scary when he's not in Awakening.
Uh-huh.
But then he hits Awakening and you're fearful for your life.
Ooh,
hit by the Red Rocket. Soji poisoning himself. But it doesn't matter because he was in the combo anyway. Counter hit.
Nice.
He's gonna kill him before Awakening.
Oh, wow.
Oh, nope. Drop the combo. Doesn't matter.
Nice.
I guess the reset.
Man, that was convincing.
It's Soji, man. He's something else. He's on a level that I don't think a lot of Americans can achieve right now. He beat Bananakin like 5-1 in the exhibition yesterday.
Yeah.
I think Lord Knight is going to have to step it up also against him.
Oh, yeah. You don't think how they're playing right now. Yeah. How they're playing right now, Soji.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, basic DP.
Oh, God.
I love that new combo from Teddy.
I know. So many, like...
Jump A.
Teddy just hits? Oh, wait. Oh, okay.
Yeah, you can late detonate the bomb.
Yeah.
Wow, Soji.
That was technically a perfect, because he only hurt himself. I don't think...
he might have gotten...
He's only in blue health, I think.
Yeah, he's just not, like, once Adachi gets an Awakening, he's, like, locked him down.
Yeah.
He's just not scared. And he's baiting every DP, like, very well. Jump C, Adachi. Oh, he tried to get tricky right there.
Ooh, the cross up.
It's just a soda can. All right, Red Rocket out.
Good nice.
Yeah.
Man, he's so good with these items.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
And that was so smart for Soju. He really wanted the corner, so he just 2D teddied himself in the corner.
This is just ridiculous.
5B, yeah, a 5B 2D teddy.
Oh, home run. Oh, no.
To the face. Soju, please. All right, Dot's trying to get stuff going. Oh, it gets crossed up into the corner.
Wow,
never seen this one before.
Oh god.
Soji.
Oh, unblockable. Oh, what?
It's so dirty.
That's
and he
sick.
Gets, and he goes for the reset. Oh.
Soji.
Oh man, Soji
That's
is ridiculous.
It.
My goodness.
That was a display of something, all right.
My goodness. I mean, he did well against Soji, I guess. It's like, it's just the neutral against Teddy is very strange, especially since there aren't so many Teddy players in the United States anymore.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
It's very unfortunate because Teddy's still a very good character.
I mean, he made him look like it, for sure.
Soji, he's something else, man. He has setups for things I have never seen before.
All right, so let's see who do we got next.
We got RUT.
Get your face out of the camera.
Jabikuto and Kamistro.
Okay.
Two newer players. I haven't really heard of them.
Yeah.
But we'll see what they're made of. This pool is very hard, so, or these first two pools are very hard. We got LK, Joshua, Soji.
Yeah, that's crazy. Like, who else is in all the other, how many pools are there?
They're, right now, they're running two pools. I'm actually in 3 and 4, which I think is next.
Okay.
So. So Minazuki mirrors.
Oh man,
I love these mirrors. It shows you who is the better player in neutral, and who can press 5A a lot better. This space control is going to be something else.
All right, let's do this. Man, I have to go with Kami for the color.
Kami.
I
like the purple?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah, just getting that air reset.
The green looks too much like he's Kick-Ass.
Kick-Ass?
Doesn't that look like his outfit in that movie?
I'm not a big fan of the green color because every time I look at a green color, it reminds me of like leprechauns, you know? It's like...
That too. I think the green with yellow stripes is straight out of that movie.
Oh wow, oh. Missed spacing. That could have been big.
Yeah, that was a lot of time.
Yeah, Kamisha right now is just running a train, yeah. Very convincing from Kamisha, but Minazuki mirrors tend to happen that way.
Yeah.
Oh,
ooh, gets the first hit.
Yeah, that second part of jump B is very hard to anti-air.
Oh, it doesn't leave him. Oh no. No punish on that DP.
There we go.
DP's out of the corner.
Nice block.
First
him into the corner.
Yeah, he wants. But then he backs up a little bit. Interesting.
Puts him in Awakening. Okay, this is where Minazuki is very threatening. Like right there, if he moon smashed it, that could have been over. Nice block. Wow.
AOA. Oh man.
No respect.
Whoa. Nice. Man.
Kamisura is just being so oppressive right now.
He can't get out of the corner.
Yeah,
oh,
and he gets counter hit by that 2B. That 2B hitbox is something else, man. I'll tell you that. Such a good anti-air. Hits twice, and both hits are anti-air.
So Persona ends today, right?
Persona, I believe the finals are tomorrow.
Okay.
Well, that's a bad time to do jump 2D.
Ooh, gets it out of the air.
Nice, gets full side switch.
Full combo to the corner.
Oh, did not cancel that 5C. 5C has a lot of recovery, don't cancel. Oh.
Nice run under.
That's not safe. That is very punishable. Wow, okay. I'm not sure what press Bunny was pressing on Wiggo.
I really feel like these people need a burst, like everyone else does, to burst right when they get an awakening. He keeps using it a little too early, I feel like.
Yeah, I mean, that's the whole mind game at this point in the Persona. It's like, yeah. Am I going to burst early and get it back later? Or am I going to burst at awakening?
Okay.
Because people tend to start baiting bursts around at, you know, that awakening time. Yeah. Nice TP.
TP's him out of the sky.
Oh, counter hit.
All right, let's see what he gets.
Wow.
Okay.
That was the hardest read I've ever seen. Trying to bait the burst.
Ooh,
nice 2B.
All right, let's see what he can get.
Oh, wow,
this.
Okay. I'll think for the easier combo.
Oh.
Try to bait a throw, but instead gets counter thrown.
Yeah.
Oh, I hate it when that happens. You think you're being really smart, and then
you just get thrown.
He does the thing you're supposed, you want him to do.
Yeah.
A little bit too quick. I mean, you have to condition your opponent to try to, like, wait a second and then throw by like making him scared and stuff.
Right.
But he was not doing that yet, so ended up not working out for him. All right, I can actually focus now.
There you go.
Welcome back, Josh, to running the stream. How's your pool going?
By the first round, I won my second match. So
is that it?
Yeah, so if I win the next match, I'll be in winner's finals.
Oh, okay. So you'll be against LK?
Yeah,
if LK wins this.
If LK wins it, if I win finals.
Yes. So it looks like Kamistro is going to be staying on, and it looks like Lord Knight.
Okay.
Yeah, Lord Knight's going to be getting on, so that's going to be fun. I know LK.
Hi, Rose Kelly, esports.
He. I know that LK does not like the, or he's not a favor of the Mini Tsuki matchup, because so many things can just happen. Like, so many things can go wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, just do that and then
ELA.
Okay.
I'll type it.
I think that'll be easier, yeah.
My last name is freaking annoying.
What kind of origin is that last name?
Egyptian.
Egyptian? You're Egyptian?
Yeah.
Wow, I could not tell.
Yeah. Half Egyptian, half Spanish. Weird combination.
I mean, it's better than my buddy is half German, half Japanese, and he comes out and he looks Hispanic. So
that's great.
It's a really funny story, because he was walking down the street or whatever, mm-hmm. and the area he's in Chicago, not that safe or whatever. And the police stopped him, and they were like, "You're an LA King. I know you are." And he's like, "I'm half white. I'm half Japanese."
That's amazing. Yeah, people pretty much can't tell what I am, which is nice. Dude, I want those godlike jeans like Leffen, half Swedish, half Korean.
Those are pretty good jeans.
Yeah.
I don't know, something about Asians and like another race, and you put them together and they just look unique.
Yeah.
We're going to the match. Okay. I think he'd be playing very safe right now.
Yeah, Kami's got the first hit, so.
Okay.
There we go.
Oh, does not convert. Goes to that jump 2D instead.
Lots of counter hits right now.
Yeah, it's hard to anti-air Minazuki when he does that jump B.
Ooh,
the fuzzy catch. Yes, nice DP. Good blocks. Now, I like the way that LK plays. He, in the first match, he'll try to figure out what kind of player you are.
Yeah.
That's a very good mentality.
Instead of just playing his game.
Yes.
Through, yeah.
Keeps it first safe.
There we go.
Not that yet. Oh, see?
There we go. Nice.
That again, that combo is not easy. That timing is so tricky.
Wow.
He's calling out his text in a button. Okay, so comfortable with this matchup right now. An awakening already. Wow, the air turn, JV. Nice, JV. No fear.
Oh,
yet again.
All right, he's in the corner. What's he gonna do? All right, okay, give him some space.
He can slide right under, yep.
Ooh, wow, that short hop.
Oh no, fatal counter.
This could be bad.
Oh, he messes up the combo though.
TP's him.
Yeah, power slash.
Oh, nice.
Power slash is such a good starter also. It's unburstable, and if you're in Awakening as Margaret, it's so much damage. It's like at least 6k, 6-7k.
Really?
Unburstable. It's ridiculous. Let's see how the rounds are. Wow, very neutral rounds there from both players. That's kind of backing off a little. You can definitely tell, like, Kamistro, in the first round, he was, like, very aggressive and, like, he wanted to be in LK's face all the time. Right now, he's, like, I could feel it. He's playing so passively now.
Okay.
He's jump canceling a lot more. Oh, the instant overhead.
Now he's stuck in the corner. Gonna try DP out.
Ooh, oh, short hop, yep. Oh, okay.
An awakening gets grabbed.
Ooh. I didn't even know that combo.
So
my
much
God.
Work.
Random move smasher.
Oh, wow, wow. Oh, what?
Okay,
what
wow.
an answer.
My goodness, that was something else. That power slash? You rarely ever get to see LKTV.
Yeah. Oh, good grab. Good time to get off this. In the corner, 2K, DP's out.
Recognize the air dash. No punish.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
Ooh.
I think he might have been flinking a little bit too much because I saw him air turn a couple times.
Yeah.
Gold burst.
All that meter.
This is a dangerous spot for
good
Fortnite.
Hits.
Push this on Awakening. I do not
there
agree with that DP, because now you are dead, sir.
Oh, what a combo.
Combo. It was a little bit too high off the ground.
Yeah.
The combos that LK do are so hard. They're optimal, but they're so hard.
There we go. 2-0 LK. Oh, LK don't look good about that.
Yeah.
Shaking his head.
I think he said he was playing a little bit sloppy today. So.
Yeah.
I mean, it's something definitely you want to be angry at yourself at. You want
right.
to, if nobody is going to call you out on your mistakes, you need to be angry at yourself.
Yeah.
That's how you get better as a player.
Yeah, yeah, because if he just sits at the top and sails out, then, yeah, it doesn't do anything.
You don't want to stagnate. You always want to strive for that zen-like state.
All right, Soju's up with his match now.
Yeah, Soju versus Dollar.
Dollar.
I believe Dollar plays
Tecto.
Yosuke? Yeah, you can see Tecto in the background. Shouts out to him. Another one
people.
Of the top contenders in this tournament.
Yeah. I remember him last year, CEO.
Oh, man, he was...
He was on a different
level. He was scary,
level.
Man. He's scary. And he was using it with Labrys.
Yeah.
Well, in Labrys, you know, in this version and the last version, not considered very strong.
All right, going straight, let's see. So, you have Teddy versus... Oh, we
Teddy
have
versus,
button check.
I think it's Yosuke. I think he can play Yosuke.
Okay.
Yep, there we go.
Oh, no one really worrying about the song. I'm just used to LK having to do that every single time.
I know, right? Nobody's going to touch that song for the rest of this tournament. Probably going to be a button check, knowing Soji.
It's a pretty godlike song, though.
It's all right. Yeah. Oh, wow. They're actually going right into it. Very rare for Soji.
All right, Yasuke getting in the corner. Oh, look at this. Let's go, Dollar.
I wonder if Soji knows this is real.
You think he thinks it's a button check?
Maybe. Maybe.
That would be so bad. No, he's going in.
All right, there we go. He's probably like, I thought it was a button check. Oh, well, whatever. Just play it out. That's not good. I want to see a fatal combo from Soji. That's so cool. Oh, I thought it would extend it.
Okay.
That was very strange from Soji right there. Yeah. You just got that random AOA.
Yeah. Oh, Teddy Persona broken right now.
Soji's very content with just blocking, keeping his face. Ooh.
So yeah, we're gonna see what happens. This looks like Yasuke's gonna take this game.
Wow,
ooh.
Soji.
Ooh.
Soji. Dollar taking a
game. Let's go, Dollar.
Soji, I think this is the first time in a long time.
Man.
Maybe it's just, maybe Soji just does not like the matchup.
Yeah. He might just not, yeah, really know what to do against Yasuke right now.
I love how Soji just stands on, like, right in front of that key.
Yeah.
And he'll get the key just whenever he thinks he needs it. Yasuke Persona broken. Another ice.
There you go. Go low. That's the best new animation.
With the taiko drums? Run.
Yeah, yeah. The drum run.
Down assault. You can see how Soji is so content and just staying away throwing items.
Oh, nice.
Wow.
Nice.
You gotta block this. Wow.
Ooh.
Soji, relentless. Relentless onslaught of attacks.
Ooh.
Red Rocket, look out. Right. Silenced.
Yep. Nice.
Yeah. That's hard.
All right, Soji firing back. Not content with losing that first round.
Yeah. Soji, I feel Soji's playing so safe in this matchup. Grabs the key. Coming back.
In the corner. What's he got?
Oh.
Hits him with a rocket.
Oh, frozen.
Oh, frozen.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Doing super?
Yep.
So much damage. In the smoke.
Yeah, that corner in the... When Soji puts that smoke bomb on top of you, and you're in the corner, you get so afraid.
Yeah.
It's like, it's not that great of an item, but at the same time, it's like, it's Soji using this item.
Right.
Drops the combo, but no tech.
Oh, man, he's running back. Yasuke's relentless right now. Keeping him in the corner, lots of pressure.
Oh, got
there
him.
There you go.
Drops the combo.
Oh, he's, like,
reset.
He's one combo away.
I think he's trying to bait the burst.
Oh, let's go, Dollar. You're so
oh, no.
close. In the corner. Get
wow,
out.
Wow, face it.
Oh, let's go.
Here we go. I don't think this is going to kill.
Oh.
Oh, this is close.
Oh, come on.
Not yet. One more mix-up.
On,
one more hit.
Yasuke.
Oh, no.
No.
And it happens just like that. Dollar.
Oh, Dollar, no.
Wow. Look at Soji's face right now.
He was one hit away from losing that game. Yeah. All right, here we go. Come on,
wow,
Dollar.
Showing America right now what he is made of.
He should be happy no matter what happens in this game.
It's like, man, I almost beat Soji.
I was one hit away, from taking the game.
Red Rocket.
Ooh, good blocks. Good block. Oh, jumps out of there.
Soji getting a little bit more aggressive now.
Oh,
now walk away from that bomb.
Here comes the barrel, burst it. Oh, gets hit. Oh, that's pretty good.
Broken. The bike. Nice. Oh. Unfortunately, no persona, but.
Wow. He's still rocking a perfect right now, though. He doesn't need the persona.
Soji.
And
wow.
A perfect.
That was very good ad lib from Soji. That was kind of ridiculous.
Let's go, Teddy. Ooh, kicked in the teeth.
It's a grab. Now Soji in this round has been just kind of taking control like so well.
Yeah. He's not letting Yasuke run his game, but right now he's going in.
He's the corner.
Good stuff.
Go for a cross up. Slide. No, he tried to glide right there. Messed it up.
Good cross up for him.
Puts himself in Awakening.
Ooh, baseball bat. Oh, nice hit.
Wow. The persona keeping Yosuke in that range.
Yeah.
That was so smart. Try to Tower Fu.
Oh, cool. Fatal hit. Pass the burst.
Soji rage. Oh, it just ran out. That's unfortunate. Five A pressure.
Oh, there we go.
Base roll. Yep.
Good hits.
Ooh. Nice. Base DP also.
Let's go, Yasuke. Oh, he's got it.
Yeah. Okay. Wow.
All right. Dollar showing that those were not flukes. He's playing so strong.
Dollar is playing smart, but like LK behind me was actually saying. Yeah. Soji says that this is probably one of Teddy's harder matchups.
Okay.
That and right next to him is Minasuke.
Yeah. Okay.
Nice blocking from Dollar right now. Very content, playing very patient. The buckets are out.
Oh, he runs out of them.
Negative. Gotta be careful right here.
Rise and rage. Oh, lots of items.
Nice block for cross-up.
Wow. Nice cross up. Gets him in the corner. Good hits.
Super.
4K.
The buckets are back.
Throws him. Oh. Parallel. Okay. All right. Yasuke finally getting his first hit in this game.
Now, this is a very scary situation for Dollar, but if anybody can do it, I believe in Dollar. Unless the Red Rocket hits him.
Unless that happened.
Oh, no. It happened again.
Oh, man.
Oh, man. I should probably get something to eat before I play my pools.
Probably.
Yeah. So okay, I'm gonna find another commentator for you.
Let's see.
Okay. Lord Knight, well, let me commentate.
Steve. What are you?
Oh, do you have to play this?
Why are you giving him my stick?
Do you have to play?
That's my stick.
Are you playing right now? Oh, okay. Because he's leaving.
He's leaving.
Yeah, I'll get to see. Yeah, dude, what's up, man?
Bro.
Haven't seen you yet since I got here.
Yeah, where have you been hiding, bro?
I flew in today at 6 in the morning.
Wow.
So I just got here. Yeah, stayed out partying last night, didn't go to sleep, jumped on a plane, still drunk, and now I'm here.
That sounds rough, man.
Yeah. It's a hard day, but I have to do it for CEO, man.
No, I understand, bro. We got back last night at 6 a.m. and had to wake up at 8 for pools.
Oh, man. Have you already played?
Yeah. No, not in Persona. I had pools in other games.
Okay, what'd you play?
I played Smash 4.
Oh, who'd you play in that?
I played Lucina.
Oh.
Doug, okay. Lucina's a really bad character.
Yes.
But listen, if you're not willing to struggle for your waifu, then she's not really your waifu.
Nah, dude, that's why I play Ryu. I switched as soon as he came out.
Okay, so there's a guy who finally modded a fight stick to play Ryu in Smash 4.
Oh.
It is so hype. I played it, I tried it too, and it works perfect.
Does
it? Amazing, yeah.
That's sick.
So if you want to play Ryu, just mod your stick. The stick modders here will do it for you. They just bring a game controller and they'll mod it for you. Yeah, it's really cool.
I think I have to do that. Yeah, I've been messing with him and messing with Lucas. I haven't played Roy as much. I need to check him out.
Yeah. Smash 4 is fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a cool game.
So what's going on here? Has Soji just been mauling people?
Soji almost lost it, if you just saw that.
Yeah, that was... Wow, like, Yosuke.
Dollar was one hit away from taking a game, like a full game off.
Oh, man,
Soji.
Dollar, please. And then, Yosuke's so good.
Yeah. And then,
I wanted to play Yosuke so bad, but I cannot glide.
Oh, no?
I can't do it. It's so hard.
You're still playing...
Mitsuru and Yukari.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
I mean, did you enter Persona?
No, I don't enter any. I don't play games. Like, I'm in law school.
Oh, man.
I don't have time to practice.
Oh, come on. Nah, I understand. It's a struggle, man. Real life struggle. This is Joshua, and this is... Oh, I know this guy. This is a Florida person. I really should know his name.
Ooh.
Don't tell me. No, I'm not going to look. I got to know. I know.
It's coming up.
Oh, M. Lorenzo. I knew it. Me and him are like best friends.
Okay.
I'm like
the worst person.
I'm actually the worst friend. Yeah,
so
we'll talk
plays, team. Do you see what controller he's playing on?
Looks like a
Logitech like PC controller.
He's using like a bootleg PS3 controller.
Like that is.
He's using like an old school Mad Catz controller.
Yeah, that is
That's really funny.
Look at Best Buy picked up a $9 controller for this tournament.
That's so funny. Oh, good sweep on that chest invuln. Not a lot of people take advantage of that. That's Joshua in the corner. Oh!
Okay.
Joshua counter hit. Oh,
drops the combo.
That was weird. He went for the three hits of auto combo into the crouch confirm, but it's a lot harder than doing the two hits.
Okay.
Oh, it's an air back. That was not the quickest low, but good block by Joshua.
Yeah, he switched to Mitsuru in this matchup. Is it something different compared to playing...
Did Joshua play another character? Yeah. I don't even know, honestly. As far as I know, Joshua was always playing Mitsuru.
Okay. Yeah, he wasn't playing her the last game he played.
Oh, who did he play?
Either Minazuki? Yeah, Minazuki.
Oh, I'm sure everybody has a pocket Minazuki.
Yeah.
Everybody has one.
Yeah, that's who it was.
No, but as far as I know, his main character is Minazuki.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, and he really, in every game, he seems to hate, like, the mirror match, so I'm not surprised.
Good combo.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, fatal counter.
Wow, Joshua
just grabbed.
Joshua fell for the burst, for the throw bait, but he got the throw anyway. Wow, good anti air. That was really risky, but it worked.
And Lorenzo going in right now.
Joshua trying to wake up EX Kudraw. That was. Nah. I mean.
Did that. He just. Yeah.
If it doesn't work the first time, you
just do it again.
That was kind of funny. M. Lorenzo taking the first round.
All right, let's go Lorenzo.
Yeah, I think M. Lorenzo used to be a Mitsuru player himself, so he definitely knows about this character. I don't think he's played Mitsuru in Ultimax, but she hasn't changed all that much.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it, like compared to some of the other characters I've been watching.
Oh, okay. That was weird.
Just hits him.
I don't know. He had the hit confirm. I don't know what he was going for. You can't charge 6B in that combo at all.
Maybe
it's a cross confirm. Oh, come on.
This is the first time he's playing this character today, so
he could be cold.
Yeah.
But I mean, those are kind of easy confirms. If you see him couching it, it's 2-3. That's the first stat. Sitting on. Okay.
Just hit him again.
I was about to analyze the situation, but he just
hit him.
He just hit him. So I'm the rest of taking the first match. Yeah, it's clear. I think Joshua kind of gets tournament nerves sometimes.
Yeah.
He's a really good player. I think he's a really solid player.
Dude, he was his first game. He was unstoppable.
Really?
Like, that's the thing. That's why it's so weird that he switched to his main, but he's playing worse.
Yeah, he really, really does not like mirror matches in any game. I don't know. I guess trying to Kudra in the middle of that block stream.
Oh, man. He's got to be rattled or something.
Yeah. Minazuki's a really, really, like, frustrating character to play against.
He's, okay.
His block streaks are so annoying. They look like they have huge gaps in them, and you just want to hit him in between stuff, but...
Yeah. Tell yourself you can't.
And yeah, and you're always kind of antsy because he has that command throw. You can't right. just hold down back. You'll get command thrown. See, like that, it just looks like he's gonna. Is he gonna stop doing the Rekka? This point, I want to hit him.
Yeah.
But then he just keeps doing it. So Emily Runs are now on match point against Joshua.
Yeah, it's convincing 2-0 if that happens.
Wow. Focus on the DP out. We're trying to bait out that Joshua DP. I think Joshua's kind of. He doesn't want to bite now. Oh no, there it is. I spoke too soon, Joshua. Yeah,
Lorenzo's in his head.
Oh no, okay. So as far as I know, that was supposed to be an EX Q draw, but he didn't have his charge.
Okay.
So if you try and do EX Q draw without a charge, you get auto attack.
Weird.
The bane of Mitsuru players.
Yeah.
It happens to everybody, all Mitsuru players. He could be dead. Oh no, Joshua's a burst.
Okay. All right.
This is Joshua's last life.
Run it back.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Oh. Okay. This is another thing. He got hit by the attack and he tried the EX Q draw. But if you're still in block zone when you try an EX Q draw, you get counter assault. Mitsuru has so many it's so easy to miss input with Mitsuru because a lot of the system mechanics and her actual inputs overlap.
Okay.
So,
yeah, you're right.
But if you're holding a charge, you try and dash throw, you'll get dash Tentarafu. It can be really frustrating.
That sounds awful, man.
Yeah, it's kind of
okay.
Sucks.
So wait. Do we have that switch?
Lord Knight sitting down.
Yeah, but why is Josh staying? What?
Wait, what?
That was Josh playing Mizuki.
That was Josh playing Mizuki?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, the names are wrong? This is the worst.
Well.
Okay, just FYI, the commentators are not in charge of the people.
We are not. We're
who
just being
put
told.
The names down. And no, it's funny, both those. Well.
Okay, so we now know that there was a reason why Josh was playing so good. And then continue.
I mean, that makes sense. Like I said, M. Lorenzo, he played Mitsuru.
Okay.
It's not like outside of the realm of possibility that he would pick a Minazuki in this game.
Okay.
But yeah, Joshua was actually the person playing Minazuki, and M. Lorenzo playing the Mitsuru.
So like I said, coming from the first game, I would think Josh is actually going to win this. Just how they were playing.
That was really funny. Okay, this is winner's finals of this pool. Okay. What number pool is this?
This is pool number
pool
one.
Pool number one. Okay. Oh, sorry. Pool number two.
Pool number two, winner's finals.
I gotta stop listening to Alex, man.
God, why does this always happen? Last year we couldn't keep track of the score. This year we can switch the name.
Oh my gosh, that was so funny, but we didn't know what the score was. I remember that. That was the best. And we thought it was over, and Alex was like, no, that was 1-1. I'm like, what? Okay, so now, man. Joshua Flame Minazuki versus Lord Knights Margaret.
What's this matchup just straight up on paper?
Minazuki plays a strong neutral game, but Margaret mid-screen and full-screen, not really much Minazuki can do about that.
Okay.
LK is very well-versed in this matchup, very likely. There's lots of Minazuki players, and I know he plays on NetPlay a lot. This is a really popular NetPlay character.
Yeah.
So I'm sure LK knows quite a bit about this matchup.
Good blocks.
Oh!
That's sick dash.
Good confirm. It's a hard knockdown
mid
screen.
Big combo.
Okay, staying very patient. Okay.
Yeah,
so
this is interesting.
Marcus' buttons are relatively slow. Minazuki, you know, he has really small gaps in between his really lame block string. His block string is literally just like one button.
Okay, good punch. Nice air dash.
Oh, oh wow. Oh, okay, with the instant overhead. That was cute.
Okay. LK played real defensively and just opened him up right there.
Yeah.
That was he just turned it on.
I still can't believe that Josh was swinging Minazuki that entire time.
We were just like, what's going on with him?
Wow, he's a roll, but wow, yeah. Joshua, it's so risky to roll and then press a button. You're so negative from a roll.
Really?
But Joshua just does it and catches LK with it.
Yeah.
I think LK was trying to bait a deep. Whoa, oh. Joshua, relax! Oh. Oh my gosh.
He just went for
yeah,
it.
Yeah, he definitely
man.
Can. Minazuki's AOE is not very fast.
Alright, Minazuki in Awakening. DP's out. Ooh, good air grab.
Yeah, it looks like the OS actually. should be it. Oh, nice. Yeah, that's it. That doesn't sound like it. Was that a, oh, that was a reset. Okay.
Yeah.
Man, I...
All right, one out.
Okay. I think Margaret's a cool-looking character. I just hate that LK plays with dumb glasses. I hate the glasses. I hate her glasses. LK does it on purpose because he knows I don't like it.
Oh, yeah, that's why he does it. Dude, I just want Persona 5 main character DLC.
I want him in this game right now.
Okay, Josh, we're going to switch to Mitsuru.
All right, there we go.
This is great. I think Mitsuru does fine in that matchup. Me and LK were talking about it. This matchup, Margaret Mitsuru is probably 5-5 also.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. But so LK never played Mitsuru in this one? All, like,
he played switch? Mitsuru before Margaret came out.
Oh, yeah, you're right. I forgot.
And you know, honestly, I'm sure he still has a really good Mitsuru in his pocket.
Yeah, so he knows what he's doing.
Since Margaret came out, I don't think I've ever seen him play Mitsuru in tournament. Okay. Or in casuals, really.
Okay.
Wow. It's about confirmed.
Okay.
Wow. Okay, yeah, Mitsuru's 5-8 too slow to punish that. LK knew that.
Good corner combo. See what he gets.
Oh wow, Joshua's complete disrespect. Just 5 days out of that. She can cancel into a lot of things from that.
But okay. Good slide.
Ooh, it's DP.
No.
Did he bite?
Nice. Nice mountain.
I'm surprised he didn't try and roll.
Nice hit. One more cancel.
Pretty big damage, but okay, does not have the meter to end this.
Oh.
Does he? Wow.
Does he?
Way
no.
More this is way more damage than I thought I was going to do.
Oh.
Like, LK ends it with a quick J2B.
Just puts the boots to the face.
That's really hard to block. She goes straight down.
Yeah.
It's so fast. Ooh. Joshua tried to hard read the jump back with 2D. Oh, yeah, I never caught LK with that.
That would have been good. Double cross up, but
okay. So the Margaret special, she'll do the first hit of 2B into a 2C, and on counter hit that's at least 4K. But the actual string itself, the first hit 2B into 2C is not real. You can DP here or just mash in between that.
Okay.
But a lot of players respect it because you have to be like mashing to hit her.
To hit it. Oh man. Oh well.
Oh well. That was quick.
Oh.
So.
Okay.
LK advances out of this pool.
Yeah, in winners.
To the surprise of nobody.
Pretty much.
Yeah, LK's Margaret's really, really good.
Yeah.
Honestly, I don't think there's any other Margaret player that's even close to his level. Yeah. Or there's any other Margaret player.
Put my name in my Twitter handle.
Oh, do you have a Twitter handle? I thought that's why I didn't.
Oh, yeah, no, dude. I'm just not.
It's the same thing. It's at DNLZ.
Yeah. I have to keep thinking if I'm going to have to like just delete that or not once I actually become a real lawyer. I feel like it's too incriminating.
You got to make it private.
Yeah, I got to start making or just come up with a
That's why I have a friend who went to law school and did the same thing.
Yeah.
Just made a problem.
Yeah. I made it through the hiring process without them saying anything. That was nice. One of the guys I was interviewing with found my Twitch, like, because they just Google you in their game for a job.
Really?
That's a weird feeling when you're in a professional job interview. They're like, tell me about this video game broadcasting stuff you do.
How'd you explain that to them?
I was just like, that's what I do for fun. And I just remember all the times I've cursed on stream, instantly went back and deleted all my archives.
there's at least like a couple hundred hours of me talking over video games on the internet. So
yeah.
I think I'm past the point of no return.
Yeah.
Up next. That was pool number 2. I don't know how far we are into pool number 1.
Yeah, no one's sitting at the console right now. Got some guy charging his phone. I always love that at tournaments when someone's like using the tournament systems to charge their
phone. That's actually
phones.
Me most of the time. But
because there's been that rumor that it affects performance.
Oh, what,
that,
really?
It draws the, like, you've never heard that?
No.
Like,
right if you're charging while you're playing?
Yeah, it like draws power from the system. Or
that
like,
sounds like a legit
stuff.
Strategy I should use. But guys, if you're just now tuning in, this is Persona Pools at CEO 2015. We just ended, I'm not sure if Losers is over in that pool, but Lord Knight just won his pool number 2. Yeah. If you want to check the brackets, it's ceogaming.challenge.com. I don't think the brackets are being updated in real time, but you can see who's in what pool.
Yeah, we don't have anybody doing that. We can pretty much tell.
Off the top of my head, Soji's in pool 1. Soji's a seeded player in pool 1. Lord Knight, the seeded player in pool 2. Bananakin seeded in pool 3, and Tectal Eastside seeded in pool number 4.
I did like that even though LK was seeded, he didn't want to do a bye because he wanted to practice.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's funny.
But it's like, I would love to be his first opponent. It's like, no, I chose to fight you just to warm up.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, guys, if you're not here, you know, I'm from Florida, so it always sounds biased when I say this, but CEO in general is just the best event that I've ever been to. I travel a lot. I go all over the United States. I've been to West Coast this year a couple times. I've been Northeast. I've been Chicago, Midwest, and just CEO is such an amazing event. I want to say if you can only travel to one event, this should definitely be the event that you travel to.
I would say so. I mean, I'm also biased for Vegas just for Evo.
Yeah, Evo.
Vegas
no, Evo's
but. Besides Evo.
Evo's Evo, but when we're talking about events that are not Evo.
That is this. Because like I said, like I've come to this every year that I've been going to tournaments. This year I was finally working. Instead of not going, I managed, 6 a.m. flight, no sleep, because I wanted to be here for 24 hours.
I had to work on Friday, actually, in South Florida. I had to call like 6 o'clock in the morning, I'm in Orlando right now, sorry.
Yeah, so like, and I'm doing that from Texas, so that was like some flights and stuff.
Yeah, that sounds rough.
Like people...
I got to make it out to Texas, man. I want to go to Texas Showdown, but something always happens every year.
Texas Showdown is always at the worst time because they put it right in finals, but everyone just shows up anyway. Yeah. But, like...
go ahead.
Texas Showdown is a great event. It's way smaller, way low-key, but that's what I like about it is that it's still in that pocket where everyone's there who knows each other and stuff like that, so I like it.
No, I was actually going to, buy a super last-minute flight this year because I think Spirit was going there. But Persona was on Friday, and I couldn't take Friday off work. So
yeah.
If it was on Saturday, I would have been like, yo, Friday night flight.
Yeah.
I'm here in Texas for one day.
Hey, it's cool. Plus, we have, Viper is a great host.
Well, I'm sorry?
Viper, Kid Viper.
Oh,
like,
Kid Viper, yeah. Kid Viper's
awesome. In Houston. And so that's the cool thing is that, like, we...
I want to turn up in Texas, man.
Yeah, at that tournament, we travel a lot. Like, we go to a lot of places.
Really?
We don't just, like, chill at the...
Yeah, I heard you guys have good barbecue places or good steak places.
Yeah, we do.
I'm about that life.
A lot of that. Austin's really good for that stuff, too. I know Dallas doesn't really have a lot of tournaments going on.
Dallas?
Yeah, not anymore. I guess we have that, like, bar fights one that some people traveled to, like, 3 years ago, but that's the last I remember.
Wait, what? So you're from Dallas, or you're from...
I don't know Austin.
I don't know anything about, like, inside of Texas. I don't know how far Dallas is from Houston or anything.
Austin, Houston, and Dallas are all about 3 hours apart. They're like a triangle.
Yeah, Texas is huge.
Austin has a lot of Smash players, and they have Arcade UFO, so they have, Eric and Donkey and them.
But Donkey's from Texas.
But we never throw tournaments in Austin. They always travel to Houston or Dallas. So we need to start throwing something in Austin.
But now you guys got you guys have a Spirit flying to Texas now.
Yeah.
So now I can finally go. I can buy some super cheap flights.
Ridiculously cheap flights. All right, so here we go. We're flying. Oh, nope.
No, this is LKA training mode. I don't know. I guess we don't have a match on deck. Sorry about that, guys. The next wave of pools starts at 2 p.m. That's actually my wave of pools. I don't really know how many more matches we have left in these two pools.
Yeah.
Persona goes pretty fast.
It really does.
People are getting bodied.
Yeah, there are a lot of 2-0s.
Yeah.
So.
And we played a lot of matches off stream, so it's very likely we might not have any matches on deck for you guys. But thanks so much for joining us. If you couldn't be here, thanks for supporting the stream.
Yeah.
We're on CEO Gaming. I guess this is an official tournament. Yeah. Yesterday we had BlazBlue on the official CEO Gaming channel, which is really cool.
Sick.
Yeah, it was a side tournament, and it was just, we got a lot of exposure for that. Soji just completely bodied everybody.
That's what I heard. I was checking Twitter while I was flying, and that's the thing also about CEO is that Jabali does not just cater to esports.
Yeah.
Like, it is, everyone gets their scene, everyone gets their time.
Yeah, it's really great.
Especially happened with Smash in the last 2 years. Smash went from nothing to its own
Smash
ballroom.
Blew up.
Everyone,
blew up.
Yeah.
And go ahead. So this is, I know both these players. These are actually both Florida players. On the left, I guess the cameras are gone. Okay. But yeah. This is Martial Law KOF. He's a Central Florida player. He plays every single fighting game. And you know the saying, Jack of all trades but master of none?
Yeah.
He's the complete definition of that. He's like a good player in every game.
Yeah.
I'll take that back. He's actually really, really good at Undernight. He's one of our best Undernight players. But yeah, he's really decent in every other game he plays.
Okay.
And then Tulink, he's a South Florida player. He actually trains with us. He's unfortunately, he plays Yukiko. Yukiko's not quite as strong in this game.
Yeah, I haven't seen Yukiko since, Hoshin playing her in the original.
Rest in peace, Hoshin. Yo, I haven't seen Hoshin in so long.
I know.
I love Hoshin. And I need him to come back.
I do, too.
I know he entered Marvel at Evo, so...
Okay, so he'll be there. Good. Yeah.
So yeah, this is gonna be a Florida team kill right here. Both these players, again, Florida natives. But they're about 3 hours apart, so they don't train together very often.
Okay.
Oh, rocking that backside of the TV. I know who chose that. Tulik knows that's my favorite song. And I think this is the best song in the game. This is the most hype.
Okay.
This was gonna be my intro music actually for CEO.
Heartful cry, so
no, there's a lot of good songs, but
yeah. Let's see. Which one's this? Oh, yeah, you're right. No, this song's good.
Yeah, this song's good.
I don't know any of the Persona names of the songs.
So, yeah, like I said, Tulink, a Yukiko player. Yukiko, not such a strong character, but Tulink's very good with her, you know?
That was a really fast burst.
He's relatively new to anime games.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Martial Law looks like he might have some tournament nerves, dropping some stuff. The command throw.
I feel like Yukiko would just get destroyed by him.
Yeah, if she gets hit, she's going to... Her defensive options are not so great. If she can keep Narukami out, if Tulin can keep Martial Law KO up out, then this is gonna happen.
Yeah,
it's very unlikely that he has this matchup experience, and I feel like a lot of people don't have Yukiko matchup experience. So if you don't know how to get in past her fans, then
yeah,
it can be rough. Oh wow, catching that swish strike with the I didn't even know that worked.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, drops
that.
Wow.
She's in the corner though. Oh, good cross up to get out.
Yeah, I think he might have been. Oh, I don't. I got the, wow, just gets hit with the unblockable. Counter stops out of there. Murakami in the corner. Oh, okay. Tries to set the unblockable. Catches him. Catches the roll.
That's it. Wow.
Nice.
If you go.
I think he rapid canceled that Augie to set up the unblockable, the high low unblockable. And if you don't roll that, you're going to get caught. It's always going to work, but even the roll. Tulink opting.
Just keeping that wall up right now.
Yeah, Marshall looking like he's having a hard time getting past his fans, but he's in now.
There we go.
He doesn't drop this. There we go.
Yep, he got it.
You keep in the corner. Good tech. Marshall backing off. This is this is not something you want to do against Yukio.
Yeah, don't give her any space.
This is where she's the strongest right now. Full screen.
Yeah, because his fireball isn't going to do anything against what she has.
Wow, okay. Ooh. Looks like he's trying to read a fan and swish strike underneath it. If Narukami can get a swish strike in the corner, that's a ton of damage.
Yeah.
And Yukiko has such low health. And it's just, unblockable.
So he's in Awakening now.
Catch some jumping. Like a mid-screen knockdown. Wow. Ooh. Chicken block. Doesn't even have to worry about that. Whoa!
Whoa! He gets got him! He's pressing!
No!
What?
What happened?
What?
That's really unfortunate.
Just slash him.
It worked. I mean, what can you even
just
say about
do
that?
It. Nothing's crazy if it works.
Yeah, Tulane's probably not very happy about that. The thing about Yukiko is, if you get hit by a fan, it's usually not a big deal. If you get counter hit by a fan, though, that's the unfortunate part.
What kind of no punish?
Yeah, it has to burst that.
Burst, yeah.
Whoa! Trying to get in there with Rage. Okay, now it looks like he's trying to stay as close to Yukiko as possible with these Raging Lions. Yeah, wow, he just wants to be in there. I mean, Yukiko doesn't really have an anti-air, so.
Yeah, he's forcing his way in.
Yeah.
He's diving at her.
Oh, good confirm. Look at that. Whoa, that was weird. Might have been a missed input.
Okay, one more is that. Interesting.
Wow. So Yukiko's DP is not very good, not very fast. It's kind of easy to. I think you can whiff a jab on it, but it does send you full screen, and that's exactly where Yukiko wants to be. Baits the counter assault, but
what?
Wow, no corner combo.
Yeah, no combo off a throw.
He might have been trying to bait a burst, I guess. It's my best guess.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, your projectiles are not going to beat Yukiko's screen.
Oh,
still trying to get in there.
Sniped out of the lion.
Good fan.
Oh,
wow. Okay, yeah, he tried to jump out of that. Oh, my gosh.
He's blocking.
Maximum ham. You can tell. I think he's getting a little frustrated being full screen against Yukiko, and he's just doing whatever it takes to get in.
Yeah.
So, Tulin taking the first match over Martial Law KOF. Those Raging Lions, though. It looked like it was working for the most part. He was
jump
getting in.
Lion, yeah.
Ooh.
He's got him in the corner already.
Okay, well, I guess out of there with a super jump, air dash. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Yeah, you can tell he doesn't want to deal with full screen at all.
No.
And that's like, he's right. You don't want to be full screen against Yukiko. There's he just loses so many options being so far away from her. So Tooling now has the unblockable.
Oh, there we go.
Okay, he gets that. Wow, just rolls out.
Nice.
Ooh, kind of hit Raging Lion. Well, he's trying to bait something out from Tooling, but
yeah,
Tooling not biting.
I guess he wants to get that slow DP out and just punish it. Yeah, just those back dashes, man.
Oh, wow, Tooling's staying very, very patient. Nice, nice. Oh, being a little bit too respectful.
Yeah.
2D is not,
yeah.
not real. Oh, I'm sorry, 5D. Oh, looked like he's trying to bait another DP, and Tooling has not been biting. But catch the counter assault. Should be death.
Yeah, I mean, he still won, but at that point, you lost so many opportunities because you kept trying to bait stuff. At one point, you just start going.
But look, he took the round anyway, so. Yeah, he's definitely trying to. He had failed counter because he was trying to switch strike, I believe. There it is again. Yeah, he just wants to be in. He's just testing his luck. Listen, honestly though, if you trade with a fan full screen, not really that bad.
And like that's the thing. The risk reward is just in his favor to just go for it. Because you haven't seen Yukiko get huge punishes yet.
He might have been again trying to bait a burst right there, but at this point he hasn't. Oh, there it is.
Oh no,
too slow to punish. Yeah. If you're not on deck for that punish, then she's gonna recover.
You finally got it though.
Yeah, he's been desperately trying to bait something this entire match. I'm thinking Raging Lion is coming.
Yeah, double jump Raging Lion. Okay.
Oh, there it is. Wow. So he's got to be getting frustrated at this point. Because it seems like whenever he tries to bait something, he's not biting. And then when he finally goes in, he gets DP'd.
Yeah. Nice.
He's out of there. I think he could have just 2B'd, but.
Ooh. Yeah, see, like, Yukiko's not getting very many combos, so it doesn't matter if he gets hit.
Oh, he gets caught with the second fan. Ooh, using that firewall to get in. Flame carpet. Oh! Okay, that was a legit punish.
Shot her.
I wonder why he didn't do that sooner, honestly. Yeah. Oh, yeah, these are two Florida players. It's all fun here, guys. Martial Law taking the second match. A very, very smart Zio punished the recovery of Yukiko's fans.
Yeah, that was sick.
So let's see. Now Martial Law knows that he does have an option when he has meter against Yukiko throwing fans full screen.
Trying to get in.
As far as I know, also EX Isen has projectile invincibility in the startup. So we can also use that to get past fans if he has a meter.
All right, has him stuck in the corner.
Doesn't want to be stuck in the corner. Raging Lion's out. Again, full screen against. Oh, wow, he's in there.
In the corner. What's he got?
Corner knockdown.
Oh, nice tech.
Oh, good confirm. Nice.
Yeah.
Again, wow. Tooling being very, very respectful. Oh, nice. It's a commentator curse right there.
Right?
Rolls out. That was kind of risky. Only 2A.
Weird. Nice kick to grab.
Looks like Martial Law's kind of finding his groove here.
He finally got his corner grab combo off.
Yeah.
Good
reaction.
Yeah. That is, yeah.
Yeah. I don't think he was just matching that. Yeah. He saw the startup. Okay, so I think he's gonna try to set up unblockable. There we go. Nothing you knew about that. Ooh, DP's out. Not a counter hit though, so can't super after that.
Yeah.
Oh, gets a counter assault. Good wrap against him by Tooling. Very smart. 10 seconds left.
Man. Yeah. Oh man. Yeah,
Martial Law doesn't even have to go in right now.
Yeah, he can just run.
Oh, he wants this.
He wants that lock.
Okay, no, he heard a time. He heard a time. It's whatever at this point. So Martial Law taking the first round of the third match with a timeout.
Timeout in Persona.
Yukiko, it can happen, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Martial Law now sitting on match point against Tooling. I'm not sure if this is winners or losers though.
Ooh, AOA. What's he got?
Nice. Does he? It's kind of weird. There's a C version in the corner. Cross up side swap. Martial Law in the corner. Oh, counter assault's out. Ooh, very smart. Raging Lion will beat that.
Ooh. Hits both sides, you do.
Just kind of hits with strike in the air. I mean, nice. He was trying to bait a DP again. Okay, so this is Tulik's last life. He needs to win this round. Nice.
Oh, no.
This should be it. Oh, no. Oh, this is the last hit.
What?
Tulik getting the second chance at life. Man, this is going to be rough to bring it.
Oh,
wow. Very smart.
It's Nagi.
And Martial Law takes it over Tulik. But shout out to playing Yukiko this far into Ultimax's life. Yukiko is not a good character. And she's not an easy character either. That's really hard.
Yeah, when you're playing a character
that's not that great, and you know, that's not easy at all. So shout out to Tulik, repping Yukiko. Like I was talking about Lucina, if you're not willing to struggle for your waifu, then Tulik definitely thinks Yukiko's best girl. Yukiko is not best girl.
Yukiko is best girl, you back off.
All right, so now we got
Soji versus.
What's his name? Oh, he's from Louisiana.
Yeah, I've seen him many, many times. He's at all of the CO tournaments.
Yep.
I should know his name. Oh, I think I stole his bag yesterday by accident. Yeah, he tweeted me. Yeah. No, we had the same bag and we both had controllers in it, and I took his by accident, so I feel bad. I know him. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm the worst with names. I'm sorry.
I know. Well, I have an excuse. I haven't been here for a year.
So I don't know how far in the pools this is. So you know if this is, of course. Yeah, we don't have a bracket here, guys. So we're just as
clueless as y'all.
Again, if you want to check out the bracket, it's cogaming.challenge.com. The brackets are not being updated in real time, but you can see who's in what bracket. And again, if you're just now tuning in, this is Persona Pools at CEO 2015. We are almost finished with Wave 1 of Pools, and starting at 2 p.m. we'll be starting Wave 2 with big names such as Tech Leaside, Bananican, and myself. I hope the song never changes. I hope they, if you don't change the song manually, it'll always stay on that song.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll play this entire tournament on the back side of the TV.
All right, let's see.
Okay, so yeah, this is Winners Finals of Pool Number 1.
Winners Finals, Pool 1, Soji and...
Soji and my friend.
And
my
yeah,
good friend.
Our boy.
Yeah. Seiken, we got button checks on deck. Yo, Soji's been button checking every single game, every single match.
Yeah.
He does not want another Turbo Gate incident. He did two button checks against Lord Knight because he doesn't trust him. After what LK did to him in NEC 2012,
oh,
dog, I wouldn't either. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
I still don't get why Turbo is still on controllers.
From the T2s, I don't think they have it anymore.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
From what I've been told, it's so you can test stuff in training mode, I guess, without really having to mash yourself. I don't know. I think it's kind of worthless too, but
yeah.
So Soji, of course, playing Teddy.
Yeah.
Seiken playing Narukami. I haven't seen Seiken play at all today or this weekend. So
yeah, I haven't either.
Could see another surprise player like that Yosuke who did very well against Soji.
Oh, he's got him in the corner, though.
Oh, Soji's getting out. Oh, JA. JA, the goat of combos. He does JA like 6 times in one combo.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, I like that blushing with the item. This is the second hit auto combo into the item. I don't know what the item's called. I just called it the ninja. Oh, wow. So he did 2B because he thought he was going to jump from the barrel, but he just got hit by it.
Yeah.
Should be dead. Yeah.
Yep.
So you take the first round very convincingly against Seiken.
Oh, man.
Seems Seiken can make the proper adjustments. Soji's honestly just like on another level. I feel like our top players, they actually do surprisingly well against him. I don't know if you saw the first of 5 yesterday.
I didn't.
Yeah, it wasn't that close, but
yeah. I mean, Soji's playing well.
Oh, gets caught low by the ninja. And he's gonna do more damage from this combo because of the rage potion. Oh no, so hard to block. And Soji working on
awakening,
perfect.
But only one card. And he's Persona.
Oh, no. He doesn't have a burst anyway, so he wouldn't be able to burst this.
Yep.
Soji with no meter and that. Nice.
And a perfect.
Just about, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Soji's taking the first match just without a thought. It's
Taken doesn't look too happy.
No.
It's rough, man. If you don't know, if you don't know everything about Teddy's items, you're gonna get blown up. You saw how he got hit by the ninja low. He probably didn't even know that was a low.
Yeah.
And I feel like a lot of players don't know either. You know, a lot of players here that haven't played against Teddy. We don't really have a proficient Teddy player.
That's right. Yeah.
So thanks, there, Josh. You.
Yeah,
you
know, Josh and girl, she's playing.
Breaker Dave. And Breaker Dave. Yeah. I don't know if Breaker Dave still plays, but anyway. Oh, so you being very patient. Out of there.
Alright, he's getting out of the corner. Good
hit.
Just
got low.
Oh, what's the grab?
Yeah, he actually OS out of there. Oh, no Raging Lion. Okay. Oh, no. Jumps back into the rocket.
That's rough.
Oh, I guess caught low. I don't know what he's trying to do. I guess trying to jump out, maybe? Tries the back dash. That's not gonna work either.
That's true.
So he let go to block. He thought Teddy was gonna not gonna cancel that.
All right, Teddy's persona broken. Into the.
I feel honestly like Teddy's still a pretty strong character without a persona.
Yeah. Good blocks. Good throw.
Good throw. Oh, trying to bait something. Soji, yeah, Soji is not gonna bite on those.
No.
As far as I know, I've only seen him DP twice this weekend, and that was in the first five.
Yeah. Oh,
the XTBs, yeah. Oh
fatal
man,
counter.
You can't do that to Teddy full screen. He doesn't meter. Okay, I think he ended that early because he wanted to fall in the barrel. But
yeah.
Oh, there's the XTBs again. 10 seconds left.
Wow, this is gonna be another. Yeah.
Oh yeah, so he's just gonna stay patient, isn't he? Oh man, yeah. So Soji taking. Was that the first
round?
Oh, okay, yeah, that was the first round.
Yeah, the round placement thing is the worst in this game. Yeah, it's always underneath the name tag.
Yeah, it's hard to see. But Soji now in match point of. He's cool now, actually. Yeah, this is weird finals. Oh, unblockable. Oh, whoa, he doesn't do anything. I think he was trying to bait a DP, I guess. But yeah, if he did anything, he can block that at all.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, so 2B because he knew he was going to try and jump over the Rage Drink. Oh, nice cross-up. Unfortunately, the Rage Drink disappeared.
Nice.
Oh, man. So he is so in control of what items. He knows, like, he always knows what items next for both his item orders.
Yeah.
And that's such a ridiculous change about Teddy. He's having two different item orders now. Yeah, EXTB punish, should be death. So Soji taking it very convincingly over Seiken in the winner's finals of his pool. Soji now advances out into top 8. Yeah, top 8. As expected.
All right, so we got Josh coming back up. I guess this is the losers from pool 2.
Yeah.
Wow, it's like that? The losers from pool 2. No, I'm kidding.
There we got all the losers on deck.
Oh man.
Losers final pool 2.
Losers final.
Okay, so
pool 2.
Losers finals of pool 2. Joshua versus another Florida player. This is, man.
Come on, dude. You're over 3
man,
right now.
Really? Stop. I know him. He's actually a South Florida player who comes to our gaming center every Friday night.
Stop trying to say people's names before the names come up.
I talk to him every single Friday. And he's actually, I've actually been on a 9-hour road trip with him by myself. And I cannot, for the love of me,
That's
or the life
amazing.
Of me, think of his name. Mech. Okay. I guess. He doesn't go by Mech in South Florida. I don't think so.
Yeah. Keep making excuses. It's okay.
So again, guys, if you're just now joining us, this is the Losers Finals of Pool Number 2 in Persona Pool Play, CEO 2015. Very good turnout. I think we had over 50 people. I think most majors that have Persona have averaged like 40, 50 people.
Okay.
That's pretty good.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, wasn't Smash 4 the most entered gamer?
Yeah, 512 people.
Yeah, beat Street Fighter.
Yes. Really, really ridiculous amount of people. Joshua coming all the way from the West Coast.
Yep.
To fight our South Florida native Akihiko player.
Oh, wow. It's funny. He's there every Friday night. I've never played as Akihiko. Sorry about that. Yeah, but from what I know, he's been practicing a lot. You know, he's a relatively new anime player.
Akihiko versus Mizuki. I can never say his freaking name.
Yeah, this is really
seems like a really hard matchup.
Minazuki really impresses a lot of characters.
Yeah, exactly.
But Akihiko does have very fast buttons. You know, both his jabs are 5 frames.
Yeah.
It's still very risky to try and counter poke Minazuki in between things, but. There you go. Nice. Yes. Oh, he's practicing. Oh, yeah. Off for the super end there. And Carlos has. Oh, just caught by the 5C. Oh.
Oh.
Yo, stay spaceship. Oh. No, he should have side swapped. He could have had. Oh, that would have been it.
He's fighting with his last breath, too, right now.
Yeah, he's definitely playing very, very patient. I like this about him. Oh, tries to jump out. So, Joshua taking that first round, but it was relatively close.
Oh, okay, he lands right into the anti-air.
Yeah, he actually landed it and not blocking. Oh, so the respect. That was ultimate respect. And Joshua getting caught by 5C3. Oh, yo, the Caesar chopping up, baby. Caesar salad. I cannot believe that. That overhead is not fast at all. Oh, man. Hopefully, Mac realizes that.
Nice.
Joshua has not yet blocked. Oh, Joshua trying to backdash that EX hook. No meter to end that. Oh, gets a 2B. Nice. Oh, no, drops it. Oh, and parries. Oh. Wow, that must have been a misinput. He got crossed up.
Yeah.
Oh, tries to DP.
Oh, no. Oh.
What?
Oh,
wow, what? Are you serious? That is top tier privilege right there.
Clash battle.
But Mech taking that round. That was kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, I can't believe that.
I think he clashed twice and then mashed out a 5D, it looked like. Nice. Snare dash. Good confirm, too. Oh, okay. Try to bait that DP, but just barely misses spaces. What I like about Mech is he's actually a really, really patient player. Looks like he might not know the matchup, but he's just committing to the block because, you know, he doesn't really know what's going on.
Okay.
Same patient block. Oh, good 2B. Wow, that was... I just ate my... Oh, my gosh! Oh. Base that DP with the EX hook. Nice. Oh, okay. He went for a cute little reset right there, the jab into 2B. Yeah. I'm surprised that didn't... Yo! Blackout, baby. This is hype. Let's see what he does. Oh, okay. Does the DS? Oh no!
Oh, wow!
Moves the DP and blackout. That's super unfortunate. I wouldn't. That's like the ultimate like guess. You can't even see. Yeah. So you're like, all right. I really hope you run into this DP. Like he was. You know what's funny? He wasn't even near him.
Yeah.
So that was that was a guess. Didn't pay off. But listen, that was a really, really, really close match.
It was. Yeah.
So I'm really, really proud of Mech. Even though I should train him. I'm sorry, Mech. He's there every Friday night. I never play with him. Scum. I'm scum. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah, she got him ready.
I didn't train anybody. I didn't play any Persona for the last month.
Oh, is Lolly here again this
year? Yeah, Homura back.
God. Not going to stop until someone's arrested.
Whoa. Oh, my gosh. Anyway. we'll talk about this off stream. Yeah. Anyway, match number two. Mech trying to poke out.
Okay, so let's see.
Wow, good internet backdash, JB.
Dude, he's still rocking that perfect right now.
Wow.
He's getting clocked by that move.
Yeah, he's getting opened up by 5C a lot. If you can get a counter hit JC, Akihiko converts so much damage from that.
Okay.
So it's a little bit slower than 5C, but if Doctor's been getting opened up by it, I try it. Instant blocks. Okay. Oh. I didn't teach him that.
Get that meter. Oh, punch.
I'm going to super end there. Oh, another 5C. Yo.
Oh, here you go.
Big damage. Joshua has no burst. Yes. He's going to get the meter. Oh, no. He's not going to enough.
Wait.
He's still a meter cooldown.
Oh. That was so.
Oh, man. That's unfortunate.
That was close. He was, what, 2 meter away from being able to kill him?
Yeah, he used. I think he rapid canceled or used an EX attack, so he was in meter cooldown. He didn't get any more meter from that combo. Oh, okay. Yeah, this should be good damage. I don't know when. Nice. Oh, he dropped it.
Dude,
I was about to say, I don't know when he learned these combos.
That re-jump combo was so sick. There you go.
Oh, drops it again. Man.
It could be nerves at this point. God, you have a job to do right now.
Oh, what's that 2B? No.
You have eight. Okay.
It's a mid-screen throw.
It's a mid-screen throw.
Oh, throw again.
Another tick throw. Wow.
Oh, man. Is this actually Persona?
Get instant blocks. Oh, I guess the air throw. Oh, my gosh.
Oh,
the read. Up.
That was the hardest read in base DP.
Hit him.
Oh my god, I don't think Meg knows that it's really, really safe to sideswap after the Narukami or maybe Minazuki with the DP.
Okay.
And he just went in. If Joshua had meter, he would have mashed out that super.
Alright.
Oh wow. Minazuki firing back.
Oh, Minazuki 5B beating Akiko's DP. I can't believe that.
this is looking bad.
Oh, take command though. He got counter hit too. He was trying to mash something out. It's looking really bad for Mech right now. Oh,
yeah,
that should be it. Joshua takes it over Mech 2-0.
Rip in peace.
You know what? He lost, but I'm really, really proud of Mech.
Yeah, he's a
soft floor player. He played really well. He dropped a few things. He looks like I said, he's a relatively new Persona player, anime player in general, honestly. But he played really well.
Good showing.
So when I get back to South Florida, I'm going to learn his name and I'm going to practice with him.
All right, let's see. So that was the end of.
That was the
all
end
of them.
That might
what
have
time
been.
Is it?
Yeah, it's almost 2 o'clock.
Okay, so yeah, we're about to get some more. It's funny that every year at CEO, more and more people wear staff shirts. I swear it's the day one thing where someone pulls the box and they just get raided.
No, the thing is, we had so many Smash players here, we needed a lot of staff.
Okay.
So I want to say like maybe half of the staff is just running Smash pools.
Okay.
Yeah, they even like they contracted me to run a Smash pool. Like I'm like, oh man. No, Smash is absolutely huge this year.
I wish I could. It's annoying for me that Smash commentary is on so much lockdown. Like,
yeah,
there's so many good.
We have a huge schedule. Yeah.
Because we have like.
Actually, I'm scheduled to commentate Smash at the same time I'm scheduled to play my pool. At the same time I'm scheduled to play my Mortal Kombat pool. Like, yeah, busy weekend.
Yeah,
no, Smash, honestly, though, Smash is really, really fun to commentate. So
yeah,
if you get a chance, I suggest trying.
Yeah, I might go jump with, what's his name? TK. Try to get him in.
So, again, shout out to Joshua for coming all the way from West Coast to run the stream for Persona.
Yeah.
Anime has its own stream this year.
Dedication.
Thank God. So we had BlazBlue last year. Yeah. We had a lot of great players. We had Apology Man, we had Lich come down.
Yeah.
LK was here. We had such a great tournament. So many good matches were played off stream.
Yeah,
it was so unfortunate because I wanted a lot of people to see some of the matches. Like Apology Man versus Lich was one of the best matches I've seen.
Yeah,
it was great. It was so heartbreaking in the end. But yeah, nobody got to see it because it wasn't on stream. But now we have our own stream.
We've
made it, guys. Anime has this, and CEO Gaming too. That's big.
Yeah,
yeah. We're not Twitch.tv/anime2015. 117. You know, this is twitch.tv/CEO Gaming, guys. So if you're enjoying the stream, please tweet us out. This is Persona Pool Play. And as far as I know, we're going to start the second wave of pools very, very soon. This is actually my wave of pools. I don't want to play on stream, though. I don't want to get bodied on stream.
Dude. After all the stuff you talk about, you got to get up there.
No way, man.
Oh, he's a hitbox player. Did you see that picture Markman tweeted about like the cherry MX switches in an arcade stick?
No, what happened?
Yeah, it was just a teaser thing, but those are the switches they use in gaming keyboards, like the cherry MX switches.
And oh, really?
So I think they're going to make a cherry fight stick, which would be amazing.
All right. I got the sweets on deck.
Man, I had to change. I was in pants. Man, it's hot. It's hot out here.
Oh, really? Yeah, it's hot in Florida, man.
Yeah.
Have you like stood outside for 10 minutes?
Well, okay, so the CEO special is this for me. Every year, it takes me about an hour to get my room where they like give me a key and I walk to one of the buildings and it doesn't work. So I walk back and I have to go into like the venue and get it from someone. So every time I come here, that's my first hour. So swear, you know, fair enough this time, go to LK, get the card, walk all the way to the room. Doesn't work. Go to the front desk. She's like, oh, you're not him. You can't get a car.
Yeah, oh my
we'll
gosh.
We'll have security escort you. And I was like, no. And yeah, so after all that, I was like, it's shorts time. I can't do jeans.
No, but it's
very, very hot outside. I don't own any shorts. I live in Florida. I don't own any shorts, but
that's bad.
I'm thinking about buying some. It's getting hotter. It's gets hotter every day.
You gotta get a pair of Chubbies. Have you seen that company?
Chubbies? No, what's that?
Yeah, whoa. They're like they're pretty short shorts.
Oh, the super short shorts.
But they have really awesome patterns. And my friend played soccer with the founders, so like he every time they come out with a new one, he gets a couple pairs. And so like that's all we have in Austin.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can pull those off.
Dude, you should try it. They have a bathing suit.
Okay, hopefully they don't DQ me.
Oh, yeah.
Right. I'm okay with that. Just DQ me.
You just don't want to get seen? Don't want to get exposed?
I haven't played in so long. I feel bad. I really wanted to practice for CEO, but I've been so busy.
What have you been up to?
Okay, so I work at a gaming center now. Okay. I have a day job, obviously, but I work at a gaming center every night. I do commentary for Smash 4, for Mortal Kombat, for a lot of different things. So
okay.
That's why I was saying, like, earlier, I have... There's like a couple hundred hours.
You're grinding now for commentating. That's good though. That's good. Get your practice up, man.
And people still hate it. Listen, no matter what, someone's always gonna hate your commentary.
Name one commentator that people don't hate.
You know, oh my god, it's the you know D1. Yeah. Everybody loves D1. His commentary is great. Went on reddit.com/SmashBros thread about how D1's commentary is getting boring and bad.
Okay, so
I give up. No one likes commentary.
Here's the thing. Yeah, no, here's the thing about commentary though, is that there's different levels of commentators, and if you're in the wrong mood for the wrong one, you can be the best at it, but I will hate you.
Yeah.
So, like, if I want, like...
If you want it to be hype and your commentators be mellow, it's like...
Yeah. If you want, like, so for me, for Smash, for Top 8, at this point, since I play Melee, so, like, since I know enough about Melee, I want informative Melee.
Yeah.
I don't want yelling and screaming.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I can get that from other games, but there's so many tiny details to why these players are playing the way they are.
Absolutely.
I need, like, and I don't fully... understand that, so I want someone to tell me why that was cool, not just yelling.
Yeah,
that it was cool.
I understand.
You know, so like, I think that commentary style is, or like at a bigger tournament, that's great. But like sometimes, yeah, I want to learn.
It just blew my mind. Like I can't believe someone would ever say D1's commentary is bad.
I don't think. Yeah, but that's the other thing. So people also, I feel like in our generation, can't say that something's good but they don't enjoy it. If they don't enjoy it, that means it's bad.
Yeah.
You should be able to say, this person's great at what they do, I just don't like them. Then, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know. I mean, on top of that, it's also the internet. Stream monsters and the internet, just anonymity, you can say anything, whatever. I don't know. That's why, no, I don't let it affect me too much. I just do what you gotta do, man.
I'm in a YouTube show with, like, JonTron, Peanut Butter Gamer, all these super big YouTubers, and half the comments are just hating on me because I'm the random. And I'm just like...
It's rough, man. The come up is rough.
Yeah, you gotta just have some tough skin. The way I see it, I'm like, hey, they're spending time talking about me. It's pretty cool. I don't know them.
No such thing as bad publicity.
Exactly.
Unless people are making up stories about you, putting things in drinks. then that's bad publicity. No drink spiking stories. That's always bad. So yeah, I'm assuming this is gonna be losers finals of pool number one. Would be nice if we had brackets, but we do not have brackets. Yeah. Okay, yeah, losers finals of pool number one.
Oh yeah, because we have
is
yeah,
it
we
pool,
got Saken back.
One or two?
Oh,
is it pool one or two?
Oh yeah, pool one.
Oh, Saken, dollar, please win because you were.
Oh yeah, Dollar's Yosuke was really, really
so
impressive.
Close to beating Soji. I don't want to see him leave. I want the run back. But Saken's also a Louisiana boy, so.
Oh, is Dollar from Louisiana also?
No, I just meant like that's why I have to go for Saken as well.
Oh, okay.
So, New Orleans is trying to level up. They have some good players that
good
meet a lot.
Ooh, oh, nice, big CB. Oh no, and takes the burst too, but not able to punish. It's gonna be rough for Dollar to bring this back.
Yeah, Saken's looking strong.
And no burst and seeing almost 100 meter though. Yosuke does big damage in Awakening.
Nice out scanner.
You're very hard to block too. Wow, just beating 5D. I guess a counter hit crouching, but Saken very early burst. I guess he just didn't want that.
No.
Doesn't want Dollar getting any momentum.
But this is dangerous now. I mean.
Oh, drops it though. Wow, that was weird. Oh no! Oh no, punish though.
It's a weird
5A hit though. It's not gonna be big damage. Oh, drops it again. Wow,
landing it every time on Soji.
Yeah, that was a 5A starter. I'm not entirely sure if that works on 5A starter, but Saken taking it. Taking the first round.
Saken had it going so well and then almost threw it away.
Yeah.
Nice.
2B clashing the first hit, second hit. Anti-air. Yeah, looks like Dollar's kind of found his groove here. Dollar usually be a very impressive, aggressive player.
Ooh.
He definitely can't let Narukami have too much space. Oh, wow.
Nice. That was late.
His DB lasts for a very long time, yeah. So it looked like he baited him. But oh, catches the backdash on Wake Up with all that attack. And drops it, though. He's going to be punished for dropping that combo. Nah, he'll be dropping those. Oh, man. Very, very tricky. I cancel Raging Lion to overhead. Ah, baits a DB again, but no punish. It looked like the combo from Dollar actually dropped. But
yeah.
He bursted anyway, yeah. So he didn't actually need the burst right there.
Close match. Oh, he's getting some damage in. Not going to be able to kill.
Maybe? I don't think this is going to kill. This does way more damage than I thought it was going to do.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, in Awakening. That, wow. Dollar taking round number two. Round final. So both players, I think both players have realized they're both very aggressive players.
Yeah.
So it can be scary to be on defense against either one of these characters.
All right, Narukami pushed into the corner.
Wow, that was actually very, very punishable, but he rolled instead of punishing.
Yeah.
Nice.
Five big
counter
hit.
Rolls past the side swap. Yeah, that's an unfortunate combo that ends that. Ends
nice.
The in the wrong direction.
Yasuke's looking real good.
Ooh. Confirmed. No meter to do anything after that, though. Wow, so Dollar working on perfect right now. Sweep should be it. Dollar taking match number one over Seiken. And Dollar's DLC is really impressive. Where did Dollar come from? I never got to.
I don't know.
Was he here last year?
I don't remember his name from last year.
I don't really remember. Definitely playing a strong Yosuke right now.
He might be new.
So we have match number two, and this is losers finals of pool number one, and I believe this is the last match of wave of the first wave of pools. And then should have wave number two starting shortly after that. I'm probably gonna hop off.
Yeah.
See if Seiken can adjust. He played really well in the first round.
He did.
Yeah, and I mean, Dollar almost brought it back, but before that, he was playing really well. I feel like either player can definitely take this. Both very strong players. I'm okay with both these players making it in the top eight.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wow, gets caught. That was weird. I don't know why he wasn't blocking. Oh,
ooh.
Wow. That's counter hit, too. I don't. He might have been trying to 2B.
Yeah, that's all I think. Try to NI air. All right. Good combo.
Ends it with a 2B. Smart to knock down, maybe? That was weird.
First. Not awakening.
Getting caught by Kunai again. Nice hit from that 5B.
Stab him.
That was super because he was right outside of awakening. Ooh. Doing big damage, but not enough. I want to see what he's going to do after this. Oh, whoa! Another drop! Wow.
Yeah.
I guess Dollar's kind of feeling the tournament nerves right now. Yeah, when I saw him playing Soji, he wasn't dropping any of those.
No, he was playing much better.
Man, I want to see players start taking advantage of the fact the counter assaults are so slow.
Yeah.
You can definitely just see it in match TP, but it's definitely something you have to practice in training mode. So he can take him the first round. Oh, trying to bait something.
Oh, yeah.
That was hot. It looked like Dollar got crossed up, too. He started walking backwards.
Yeah.
Oh, AOA.
He's got him in the corner. Nice. Nice.
Okay, wow. Okay.
Good damage.
Yeah, text in the air, though. Doesn't get knocked down.
Yeah.
Oh, tries to go. Goes for the unblockable. So slow.
Yeah, really.
Smash
is.
Out of that.
That back looking so good.
Oh wow, gets caught by the 5C. What happened? Yes, he counters out so slow. The block.
Come on, Dollar.
Oh, Satan Burst. Sitting on 130.
Oh, there he goes. Now he's in Awakening.
That's an Awakening. Very smart.
Wow.
Oh, oh. Oh my gosh.
Why?
Yeah, definitely the wrong super. The other,
Oh, nice catch. Nice catch.
Yeah, he definitely had meter for EX Margarula, but is this gonna end it? I don't know. I don't think it's
gonna.
No, yeah. That super always does more damage than I think it's gonna do, but
yeah, not enough right there.
No. Whiffs the counter soft, but no punish. Good blocking. Oh wow, I guess he was trying to bait DP, but Saken rolling instead. Dollar now on match point. Counter hit, wow.
Nice.
I don't know what he's pressing. That looked like should have been a clean 2B, but. Oh, it's caught, wow. It's caught not blocking low. I don't know what he was pressing on wake up. It wasn't a counter hit, so he just wasn't holding back.
Yeah, Saken's just kind of running right now. Oh, okay, wait.
Wow, that was that was risky, and yeah, he gets punished for that.
There you go.
Yeah, you can tell the Saken's. Oh, there we go.
Go.
Only 5-8 punish, though.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Aw. That was close. Alright, what's Yasuo gonna do his combo?
Okay, so, Saken now. Still has 91 meter. It's gonna be an awakening, but. Saken gets a good hit confirm.
Oh, that should be it.
That's gonna be it? Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
This is it. That's unfortunate. Saken taking it. That was 2-0 over. I'm sorry, Dollar taking it. That was 2-0 over Saken.
Yep.
Good showing by Dollar. Now we're gonna have a Yosuke in top 8. I haven't seen a Yosuke in top 8 in a very, very long time. But I'm scared now because I really don't want to play Yosuke. Man, I wanted Saken to win, but. Okay, so that is the end of the first wave of pools.
Yeah.
Persona Pools, the CEO 2015. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. And it's already 2 o'clock, so I guess we're going to go right into wave 2 starting, but I have to pee.
Go for it.
Yeah, I'm going to try and get Dasibro on commentary, wherever he is.
Oh, God.
I know people love Dasibro's commentary. Or maybe I can get Homu on commentary again. Oh, are we going to take a break?
Okay,
I guess we're going to have a short intermission between the waves of pools. I know you guys wanted to see Homu on commentary, but I know Yoshiki wanted to see
it. All right, guys.
All right, yeah.
Thanks for watching.
We'll be out.